And also other types of the injuries. So we can see the different type of head injuries will give the symptoms. So diffuse injuries and also focal injuries. So what are the diffusion injuries? That is going to be the concussions, and also axonal damage is going to be diffuse injuries. Focal injuries are going to be contusions, lacerations, and also epidural hemorrhage, subdural hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage, and also intracerebral hemorrhage. So is going to, these are going to give the severe, like the focal signs, focal symptoms we are going to observe. So that is related to completely the neuronal damage. So here, what is the concussion, and also what is the diffuse axonal injury we can discuss here. So concussion is nothing but is a brain injury that occurs when the brain bounces against the heart wall. So if anything hit to the heart wall, the brain is going to be like a bouncing against the heart walls. So they may chance to get the symptoms. So that is the concussions. So generally speaking, the loss of the functions associated with the concussion is a temporary. So concussion is if any hit injury is a frontal, okay, here frontal bone injury hit to the any object. So what happened, because of the force, the head is going to get the bounce once. So because of the bounce, the effect is going to be the opposite side. So there is going to get the like a good the injury, but the effect is not at the injury site. So because of these things, so they are going to get the loss of consciousness, but it will be temporary. So because of this violence, because of bouncing, so if it is, they are going to get the loss of consciousness. If it is repeated the continuous like a loss of consciousness, so they may chance to get the temporary damage. So the loss of consciousness is going to be temporary. But if it is continuous, if it repeated, so this is going to give the permanent damages. So what are the causes of these concussions? So it's going to be the stretching of the white matter, shearing or stretching of the white matter fibers at the time of the impact. So it may give the temporary neuronal damage. So that is about the concussion. And also, so we have to understand about the what is a contusion and concussions. So contusion means is going to be affect the severe injury because of the injury site. The site is going to give the hemorrhage, and also they're going to get unconsciousness is more prone than a few seconds, minutes. So that means it's a more the prolonged time they're going to get the contusions. So because of the violence force at the injury site. So these are about this is a contusion. Contusion is going to be affected the injury site. If the injury at the frontal region, the problem is going to be, and also they're going to affect the frontal region. Concussion means because of the injury at the frontal region, because of the bouncing of the brain, so they are going to get the complications. So it may stretch the white matters. So because of the stretching of the white matter, they're going to get the temporary neuronal damage. So because of the concussion, they're going to get the brief the confusion. Disorientations. Maybe if you see any patients after accident or maybe head injury or any like a road traffic accidents, few minutes is going to be like a confusion. If it's a mild injury of the get up because of the concussion, only like a hitting at some place, if it's the brain bouncing, bounce, so they're going to, after get up, they're going to be confused. That means that they're not going to be disoriented. That means they cannot speak properly or maybe confusion. Sometimes they may chance to get the stupor or delirium. So unable, that's not complete coma, or maybe they feel the cloudiness. And also next, that is the another important symptom is going to, they will feel the headache, dizziness. That means they're going to feel the giddiness and also like a vertigo symptoms. And also amnesia, loss of memory. So some, the few seconds may chance to get the memory loss. Depends upon the severity of the concussion. They may chance to get the like recent memory or remote memory. Or maybe he's going to get the return of the consciousness movement or minutes after the impact. So within the 30 minutes, they're going to be the normal. Sometimes depends upon the severity, they may get the recovery within the few minutes, within 5 minutes. So that is about the concussion. But if you see in the brain, like in the CT scan and MRI scan, so there is no effects we can see in the CT scan and MRI scan. So it shows the normal. So that is the concussion effects. And also after the post-concussive syndromes, so after the injury, if it is not, it's not cured properly, so it may progress or repeated concussion episodes or loss of consciousness or other symptoms. So may chance to get, so within the, until the 2 months. So if the post after concussion, if any symptoms occur within the 2 weeks to 2 months, so it is called as post-concussive syndrome. So in the post-concussive syndromes, so they are going to get the complaints will be the persistent headache. They are going to get feel the severe headache. and also fatigue, tiredness, and personality changes. Personality changes means they are going to get the like a depression, anxiety, or maybe unable to sleep properly, insomnia. So these type of problems they are going to feel, and also short attention span. So they are unable to concentrate anything. So unable to like a concentrate to do any work or to learn also some problem, and also decrease the short term memory. So they are unable to memorize the short term memory, whatever we show, so they may chance to forget. And also sleep disturbances, so especially some people may chance to get the like a oversleep, or some people are going to get the less sleep or insomnia may chance to get. And also depression, personality disorders may chance to get after the concussion effect within the 2 to 2 months.